it out. Just cut loose. And some folks, oh, how nice. And like, no, but what you don't understand is that's a revolution. That's a revolution worship. What? I'm going to preach now. Can I? I'm going to bring it on home. What is happening is that when he was playing that, he was releasing something in the heavenlies. There has been stuff that has been stuck up there. There has been stuff. Whatever you lose on earth, he was loosening something on earth. Don't get fake with me now. needed somebody to come over and lift my hand up for me.
Come on.
And I needed somebody to tell me in such a way to tell me it ain't over.
Come on.
It ain't over. Even though I felt like it was over. And so as I'm having this conversation with God, he said, by the extending of your hands. See, we come in and all the worship. Worship is great. Worship is wonderful. When the worship leader comes up and they tell you, come on, lift your hands towards heaven. The lifting of your hands is not something we're doing out of tradition. What they're trying to do is trying to get you to lose some things. They're trying to get you to lose some things. When the pastor gets up here, it's not just to eat up time and to tear up your Sunday when he gets up here. Come on, lift your hands towards heaven and praise the Lord. It is to let you know that you're loosening something down here. And when you loosen something down here, something is getting ready to be released up into heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound. You've been in the fight, you've been in the war, but I double dog dare you to lift your hands towards heaven and begin to worship. Are you ready? I gotta get out of here. I'm way past my time on a Wednesday. Y'all been wonderful, y'all been great, but when I count to three, I want you to get out of your seat. I want you to find three people, and this is all I want you to do because I don't know. There might be a Kenan Alexander here. There might be somebody who's been in the battle. Who's in the battle? Who's going through it? Here's what I want you to do. When I count to three, all you're going to do is you're going to walk over to three. Extend your hand out, girl. You're going to grab their hand. You're going to lift it up towards heaven and say, it ain't over, baby. It ain't over. It ain't. And you're going to let them know it ain't over. They've been needing a release. They've been wanting a release. They've been praying about it. They felt like God has left. Listen. I was preaching in front of. So can I? Thank you. Woo! Can I just talk to you for a moment?
Come on.
Man, I thought God left me.
Come on.
I did. I thought, man. Has anyone ever felt that, or am I by myself?
Oh, man.
I felt like I understand, you know, the scriptures, and you know, we all know it even from Sunday school, you know, for God so loved the world. You know, he loves you. He'll never leave you nor forsake you. I feel so far away, God. Why would you, I don't know if you ever said this, why would you allow?
Come on.
Why would you allow that, God? Why?
Come on.
Why? And as I was going through this, I was needing a release of his joy and peace. I don't tell too many people this, but I'm going to tell you because I love you guys. So I'm back at the bedroom. All right, don't be putting my stuff on Facebook, y'all. So I was in the bedroom. I didn't want the lights on. I didn't want out of the bedroom. I didn't want the lights on. Sorry.
With family.
Kids were asking, what's wrong with daddy? Didn't want to go nowhere. Didn't want to be around anybody. Wouldn't return the text. The only time I would leave the house is on Sunday to go preach. Not preach, preach like a fool. I tell the pastor, oh no, I'm not feeling all that well. I don't want to go out to eat. And I just go and lay in my hotel room. Just curl up. Just wait till it's time to go and preach again the next night. And one day, I'll never forget it. I was laying in the bedroom with my wife. So let's go get some pizza or something. No, I don't go nowhere. And just feeling like God just left. And she closed the door, said, all right, I'll leave you alone. And I don't know what happened. sudden, that door busted back open. And she flipped. I was like, no, turn the lights off. She's like, no. Enough is enough. I said, but you don't know what I'm going through. You don't know. She said, all I know is that God's got a plan for you and God's got a purpose, and you're not going to shrivel up in here and let it go away. And here's what she did that changed my life. Changed the way I preach, changed the way I do everything. She grabbed my hand in that bedroom. She lifted my hands, and she, in the bedroom, we walked. And this is how I walked with me. We walked together. Of course, my bedroom's not this big. It'd be nice, though. But, and we walked, and we just walked back and forth, and she just started worshiping. And she started worshiping, and I'll never forget it. When she lifted my hands, it was like my hands, at first, I was like, she was doing it all. And then gradually, it was like, last thing, and I get out of your hair with it to explain how I felt. I don't watch wrestling now, but how many watch wrestling way back in the day, like with Hulk Hogan and stuff, right? And y'all familiar? And what they would do is when you thought the wrestler was down and out, they'd get him in a figure four or something like that, and they thought the wrestler was out, right? And the day he'd come over, he'd go, why? And he'd grab his hand, and he'd lift his hand, and he'd let it back down. And then he'd try to lift it, and he'd go back down. Then all of a sudden, I don't know if it was Hulk Hogan or who the wrestler was, but all of a sudden, he'd grab his hand, and they were expecting it to go down, but all of a sudden, the hand started. Y'all know what I'm talking about? And that hand started going like this, and that hand was starting. And it was a sign to everybody around that I might have been knocked down, but I'm not out.
Your house after service just like this. Walk in there, brush your teeth. Put your